Thank you. Thank you very much. For those of you who just joined us, the topic today is my father is evil and he wants to take over the world. Okay, let's meet Scott Evil. Hi, Scott. Nice to have you here with us. Tell us about your father. My dad is the head of a worldwide evil organization with aspirations of world domination. Pretty serious stuff. Where is he now? He's like cryogenically frozen, orbiting the Earth or something. Well, that's what you think. We have a surprise for you, Scott. What? Okay, let's bring out Scott's father, Dr. Evil. Boo! What? Hello, Scott. Daddy's back. How could you do this to me on national television? You threw me a frickin' bone here, Scott. Why'd you run out on me? 'Cause you're not quite evil enough. Well, it's true. You're quasi-evil. You're semi-evil. You're the margarine of evil. You're the Diet Coke of evil. Just one calorie, not evil enough. What are you, some kind of freak? Hey, shut up! I'll kick your punk! Bring it on, you skanky! Okay. Settle down. Everyone talks to my son like that. Let's all be mature about this. You mother... Jerry! Okay, thank you. Yes, I'm fine. You were born in your mother's... I'll kill you both! I got your hood! I got your hood! I got your hood, you... Settle down. Okay, settle down. Calm down. Calm down. It's just a TV show. Calm down. Okay, I'm okay. Get this jerk out of here. I'll give you... you piece of... Ah! He's biting me! He's biting me! The... is biting me! The world is mine! The world is mine, mother... You've got mail. Hello, Basil. Hello, Austin. How was your honeymoon? Well, it turns out Vanessa was a fembot. Yes, we knew all along, sadly. Anyway, I have a new assignment for you. You're assigned for a model shoot, and one of the models works for Dr. Evil. Groovy, baby! Shagwar! Show me to the models, baby. Let the magic begin. Who have we got today? Austin Powers, I've heard a lot about you. I'm Rebecca Romaine. I don't think I've had the pleasure. Well, of course you haven't had the pleasure, Rebecca. We just met, baby. Yeah. Who are you, baby? Ivana. Ivana Humpalot. Excuse me? Ivana Humpalot. An Ivana toilet seat made out of solid gold. It's just not in the bag yet, is it, baby? Okay, everyone, let's get started.
Let's get started. Yes, beautiful. Feeling it. Let's get some smiles all in here. That's it, yes. Let the inside out. Okay, you're an animal. Yes, there we go. You're a tiger. You're turning into tiger. You're great. Very good. Loving it. Now you're a lemur. Running in the past. Yes, yes, you're left. You're right. Yes, yes, yes. The predator out of the jungle. Here we go. Burrow. Burrow. That's right, you're a lemur. It's all you've got. You don't have sharp teeth capable of fighting. Make an interconnected series of tunnels like the Viet Cong. And look. I'm not even shooting you. It's crazy. And I'm
Miss Humpalot. Darling. Shall we? Give me a moment. Yes! Dr. Evil, several years ago, we invested in a small Seattle-based coffee company. Today, Starbucks offers premium quality coffee at affordable prices. Delish! If we shift our resources away from evil empires and towards Starbucks, we can increase our profits fivefold. Number two, I make the decisions here, okay? I demand a little respect. Dr. Evil, you have a little silence! I will not tolerate your insolence. Frau Farbissina, we get his in. Say good, sir, doctor. How are things? I have come to embrace the love that dare not speak its name. To my right is my lover. Her name is Unibrow. Right on. Doctor?
What?
You have a little milk nose mustache. I knew. Meant to. That's how we drink it in Belgium. Called a Belgian dip. Yeah. Dr. Evil, while you were frozen, we began a process to clone you. Cool.
Send in the clone!
He is exactly like you in every way. Except 1/8 your size. Breathtaking. I shall call him Mini-Me. Your stock is rising, number two. Come, Mr. Bigglesworth! Ew. Mini-Me? Are you hungry? Something to eat? Not even a Hot Pocket? An Eggo? No? Leave Mini Mr. Bigglesworth alone. We don't gnaw on our kitty. Just stroke him, love him. Okay. As you know, every diabolical scheme I have hatched has been foiled by Austin Powers. Why is that, ladies and gentlemen? Because you never kill him when you get the chance and you're a big idiot? No! Down, Mini-Me! No, Austin Powers always defeats me because he has mojo. mojo, the libido, the life force, the essence, the right stuff. Something that the French call a certain, I don't know what. Ladies and gentlemen, I've developed a device for time traveling which I call a time machine. Using this time machine, I'm going to go back to the 60s and steal Austin Powers' mojo. If you have a time machine, why not use it to go back in time and kill Austin Powers while he's sitting on the crapper or something? How about no, Scott? Okay? Why not use your knowledge of the future to play the stock markets? We could make trillions. Why make trillions when we could make billions? A trillion is more than a billion, numbnuts. Alright, zip it. Look, you can't just zip it. Zip. I'm just trying to, ladies and gentlemen of the court, exhibit A. Number two, would you, look, I'm Zippy Longstocking. Look, I just.
Why bring the war, Mr. Iwato?
Subtitle, zip it. Frau, would you please, when a problem comes along, you might zip it?
Whatch! Zip it good!
I'm just trying to zip. Would you like to have a suckle of my zipple? I just, stop, zip it! All it, zip it! You know what, zip it! God, you're such a child, isn't it? You just one time, zip it! Zip it. Unveil the time portal. As you knew, Austin Powers was frozen in 1967. Therefore, I will travel to 1969. 2 years after he was frozen. He'll be helpless. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm about to travel through time. I bid you adieu. Oh! It's not... I'm okay. It's not turned on, is it? Do you think you could... Thanks. Come, Mini-Me! Don't be scared, Mini-Me. Dr.Evil, welcome to 1969. Thank you, number two. You look so healthy and youthful. Well, thank you. Herr Doctor. And Frau, you look so... Right. I received your memo from the future. Your new layer is up and running. Is it a hollowed out volcano like I asked for? Of course. Then it's all going perfectly to plan. Then did you get the clapper? 1964, Dutch East Indies, surely. Do you know how we keep warm in Russia? I can guess, baby. We played chess. I guessed wrong. It takes a key intellect to play chess. I assume you know how to play. Of course, baby.
to do, what to do. Alright, let me ask you a question, baby. And be honest, do I make you horny? Randy, do I make you horny, baby? Yeah! No more games. Dr.Evil sent me here to kill you, but I just find you so sexy and just make love to me. Hurry, Austin Powerovich. You are heady, like animal. Grr, baby, very grr. Make love to me, monkey man.
Dr. Evil, I don't understand how we can hope to steal Austin Powers' mojo. We've tried this before. The security around is foolproof. But this time, we have an operative inside the Ministry of Defense.
Really?
Really. He's stealing Austin Powers' mojo even as we speak.
Really?
Really. He's a disgruntled old spy in the Ministry of Defense from Scotland. He is well known for his bad temper and his unusual eating habits. He weighs a metric ton. His name? Fat Bastard. We've had reports of a spy in the Ministry of Defense. Be on special alert.
Yes, sir!
And, try to lose some weight, for God's sake!
Yes, sir! Mr. English Journal telling me to lose weight. Ooh, I'm a hot guess, he says. Well, listen up, sonny Jim. Ah, it's a baby. Oh, hey, baby. It's what's on the menu. Baby, it's what's for dinner. Oh, I got your mojo now, sonny Jim.
What's wrong? Crikey! I lost my mojo!
Austin, the test results confirm that you have lost your mojo. And it couldn't have come at a worse time. We have evidence that Dr. Evil has developed a time machine and has traveled back to the year of 1969. Luckily, we too have developed a time travel device. This is where you input your destination. Wait a tick. Basil, if I travel back to 1969 and I was frozen in 1967, presumably I could go visit my frozen self, but if I'm still frozen in 1967, how could I have been unthawed in the 90s and travel back? Oh no, I've gone cross-eyed. I suggest you don't worry about this sort of thing and just enjoy yourself. That goes for you all too. Yes. Well, this is smashing, Basil. I go back to the 60s, recharge my mojo,
defeat Dr. Evil, and be back in time for tea. Swinging 60s, here I come, baby! Yeah! Sorry! I bet that's expensive.
Oh, alright, move! Oh, okay, here we go!
Godspeed, Austin.
Swallows. That's an interesting name.
Maiden name, Spitz.
Well, which is it, baby? Spitz or Swallows?
Skin tight. How do I get into those pants, baby?
You could start by buying me a drink.
Yaha! I want!
Better play it cool, your friend works for Dr. Evil.
And just who do you work for, baby?
Tell me, Mr. Powers, do you swing?
Are you kidding, baby? I put the GAR in swinger, baby!
Then why don't you come right over here.
Prepare to die, Powers!
Use the machine gun! Yeah! use the bazooka!
No! No!
Ah! Ah! The four will kill us both, powers! You can't win, powers! Why won't you die?
Ah.
Care for a ride? Oh! Austin Powers, I presume?
Powers by name, Powers by reputation.
Felicity Shagwell, CIA. Shagwell by name, Shag very well by reputation.
Oh, behave.
Not if I can help it. You know, it's funny how England looks in no way like Southern California. We got company. It might be one of Dr. Evil's assassins. Do you remember me? Austin Powers?
I don't recall your name, but your fez is familiar.
My name is Mustafa, and I be the man who killing you now. Dr. E!
Who sent you?
You'll have to torture me. You'll have to kill me.
Who sent you?
Kiss my ass, Powers!
Who sent you?
Dr. Evil!
Wow, that was fast.
Yeah, that was fast.
Why'd you tell us?
I can't stand to be asked the same question three times. It just irritates me.
Where's Dr. Evil hiding?
Why would he tell me? I'm just one of his low-level functionaries.
Where's Dr. Evil hiding?
You'll have to torture me. I'll never tell you.
Where's Dr. Evil hiding?
Damn, three times. Okay, he's hiding in his secret volcano lair.
Where's Dr. Evil's secret volcano lair?
I spit at the question.
Do I really have to ask you two more times?
Go to hell, Powers! Fine. Where is Dr. Evil's secret volcano lair? I will take it to the grave with-
Aha! You have to answer him. And he asked you three times.
No! The second question was, do I really have to ask you two more times? But in a new line of questioning. So that would be the first in a new line of questioning and wouldn't count in the other line of questioning.
You know, he's right. However, I'm trying to get information from you, man. I don't need any consistency in the questioning, do I?
No, you're not preaching to the converted.
Well, if I'm not preaching to the converted, then why are you being so slavish to the asking three times thing? You're not even looking at me, man. Now you're just being rude.
Well, Austin, looks like you finally met your match.
Oh no, baby. I've beaten Dr. Evil before. I'll beat him again.
I was talking about me.
Hello there. I seem to have fallen down a cliff. I'm still alive, but I'm very badly injured. I think my legs are broken. I'll try to stand up. Oh, yes, they are broken. Perhaps you could toss me a band-aid or some antibacterial cream. I'm in an extraordinarily large amount of pain. The bone has gone through the skin. I fear it might be dangerous. The wound is beginning to smell a little like almonds, which is not good. Please? No one? Alright, I'll try the other leg. Ah!
Two of my spies are dead. I will not tolerate failure. I'm the man who will maintain the greatness of this evil organization. What the hell was that? Volcanic eruption. May I present to you my spy in the Ministry of Defense? Fat bastard.
First things first, where's your shitter? I got a turtle head poking out.
Charming.
I'm not kidding. I got crap on deck that could choke a donkey. Oh, it's squidgy. Ah, Christ, I'm getting all emotional from it, you know?
Right. Fat bastard, could I have my mojo?
Where's my money? Jesus Christ, he's tiny! I've had bigger chunks of corn in my crap!
Wait a minute. He kinda looks like a baby.
Come here, I'm gonna eat ya! I'm bigger than you, I'm higher on the food chain! Get in my belly! Come here! Oh! Oh! You're a lucky wee man, ah! Ah!
Could I have a hug?
Dr. Evil, let me make you a deal, alright? You get the mojo, you keep your money, and I'll get your baby.
Right.
I want my baby back, baby back, baby back, baby back, baby back, ribs. I want my baby back, baby back, baby back, baby back, baby back, ribs.
Excuse me.
Chili, baby back ribs.
Dr. Evil, what are we going to do about Austin Powers?
Austin Powers is no longer a threat to me. I have his mojo.
Alright everyone, you're dismissed.
Dr. Evil, I don't want this to interfere with our work.
Don't worry, Mama. Things won't get weird. One for me, and one for my homies.
Hey, doctor.
So what happened here? Apparently a rogue agent named Fat Bastard infiltrated the unit assigned to guard your cryogenic chamber. He used some sort of nerve gas. These men don't remember a thing. Captain, why don't you cross-check Fat Bastard's profile with the main mainframe at Langley.
Can I borrow this, please?
Yes,
Yes, yes, work it, Austin. Yes, look at me, I'm a sexy bitch, baby, yeah. You're a popsicle.
Oh. Oh.
Yes, yes, and I'm spent. Let's go, baby, yeah. Shall we sit down? This is great. Groovy.
So Austin, what's the future like?
Well, everyone has a flying car, entire meals come in pill form, and the Earth's ruled by damn dirty apes!
Oh my god.
Had you for a second.
You can have me even longer if you want.
You're one groovy baby. Baby. Too many babies. Don't you dare move. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Burt Bacharach and Mr. Elvis Costello. You're quite good on your feet. I'm even better off my feet.
Hi. Hi there.
How are things?
So good, sir, doctor.
And you? Great. Just taking a break. Try the Hot Pockets. They're breathtaking. It got weird, didn't it? Yeah. I knew it. You haven't called. Look, we talked about this. We promised each other it wouldn't get weird. I can't let my feelings for you interfere with my taking over the world. You know that. You know, I will never love another man. Yes, that's true. Dr. Evil. I'm late. No, you're not late. You got here right on time. No, I mean, I'm late. Oh. Dad! Scott!
Hey there, sport. How are you?
What are you doing here?
Look, you know, I know I've been kind of a smartass at how, you know, but, I mean, you know, you're my father, and I just want to work things out.
Scott, you had your chance, okay?
I have already created someone in my image. He's evil, he wants to take over the world, and he fits most easily into most overhead storage bins.
Wait, him? Look at him, he's crazy! He's like a vicious little chihuahua thing! He'll kill me the first chance he gets.
Probably. I love you. You complete me.
I am a sexy bitch, baby. Felicity, make yourself at home. What do you think of my shake pad, darling? It's amazing, Austin. What do you think? That's how my mojo is still in that bastard. No, she's a professional agent. She's not interested in shagging. Oh, please, God. Spectacles, testicles, wallet, and watch. Austin, I'm waiting. How about you give me one of your famous sexual massages? You mean a sensual message? Right then, here we go. Wait a minute, something's itching me. Crikey. That's better. How does that feel, baby? Lower. How does that feel, baby? You don't have to be cute with me. We're way past that. We are? What do you think? Listen, Felicity. I can't do this. I'm sorry. I have to go. Is it me? I can't explain. Hello, Agent Shagwell. Where's Austin? I must have said something wrong, so he took off all of a sudden. Listen, I don't want you getting too close to Austin. It's not meant to be. I don't get too close to anybody, Basil. My interest in this case is purely professional. Then you won't mind checking down Fat Boston tonight. No problem. We need you to plant this homing device on him by any means necessary. No problem. Keep up the good work. Remember, by any means necessary. Look at yourself. You used to be so virile. You were a swinger man. Now you're nothing. At least it can't get any worse.
Well, surprise, surprise! Look at that, meal, huh? I'm dead sexy. Oh, look at my sexy body. By the way, you like some chicken? I got more.
No thanks.
Remember, by any means necessary. Frisky, are we? Gear it up! Ladies and gentlemen, we're about to begin phase 2 of our evil project. Or is it face? I don't know faces. Anyways, this is the face in which we put a giant laser on the moon. As you know, the moon rotates around the Earth like so. When the moon reaches its appropriate lunar alignment, it will destroy Washington, D.C. You see, I turned the moon into what I like to call a Death Star. Oh my god. What? Oh, nothing, Darth. What did you call me? Oh, nothing. Rip off! Bless you. Anyways, the key to this plan is the giant laser. It was invented by the noted Cambridge scientist Dr. Parsons. Therefore, we shall call it the Alan Parsons Project. Oh my god. What now? The Alan Parsons Project is a progressive rock band in 1982. I mean, why don't you just call it Operation Wang Chung, ass? What did you say? Oh, nothing, I'm sure. But Operation Bananarama will go great. What are you saying? You know, if you want to trying to be hip, www.sh.com.org. You're so Dr. Evil, if we could put aside the family squabbling for a moment, I think we should get to some serious this business here. Really? I didn't like that insolent tone. I meant nothing by it. No, you want to learn things? No, not at all. Oh, you want to be daddy, is that it? Number two, do you want to wear the daddy pants? You're going to cry? You're going to cry, number two? No, going to squirt some? No, You see, you're going to cry. You're a big man. And now, thought so. Listen, Felicity. About last night. You don't have to explain often. No, you don't understand. You see, I'm off my mojo. Oh, so that's why you... Yes! I thought you didn't like me. Oh no, baby. You're very shagadelic. I just didn't want to fall in love again. And I thought you'd never love me without my mojo. Not you. You're fab. You're great. You're fab. You're a bit of all right. That's so great. Something I should tell you. Last night, I planted a homing device on Fat Bastard. Smashing. Then we can track down Fat Bastard, get my mojo, get back to my thing, hop on the good foot and do the bad thing. But there's more. In order to get close to Fat Bastard, I have to... Hello, hello? Signal's coming through. It's a padding sensation. Let's go!
Where is he, baby?
Through here. We got him. Private. Bring up the RAM. Where is he? Oh my god! That bastard left us a present! Oh, in the name of all things sacred, that is the most foul-smelling thing ever! Somebody flush it down. No, we have to take this to the lab to be analyzed. Come on.
Austin, how are the tests coming in?
Cool, baby. You look very shagadelic. Yeah!
But do we really have to be here, Felicity? I mean, it's so boring. I don't believe in science. When it comes to the spy game, it's all instinct.
Hello, everybody. Hello, Basil. The results are in. We've discovered trace marks of a rare vegetable found only on one island.
What does it all mean, Basil? It means this is the location of Dr. Evil's lair.
Cool.
Basil, this coffee smells like shit. Austin, it is shit.
Oh good, then it's not just me.
It's a bit nutty.
Dr. Evil. I have to speak to you about this mini-me. What? Is he not fitting in? Is he giving off too much of the creepy Oompa Loompa vibe? No, it's just that he bites. He's a biter. What's wrong, Mini-Me? Something you want to tell us? Teething. Get me the President of the United States! Oh, he's on. What do you want, Dr. Evil? Mr. President, in 12 hours I will destroy Washington, D.C. with a giant laser. Mini-Me, stop humping the laser. Honest to God, why don't you and the laser get a frickin' room for God's sakes? Mr. President, after I destroy Washington, D.C., I will destroy another major city every hour on the hour. That is unless, of course, you pay me $100 billion.
Dr. Evil, it's 1969. That kind of money doesn't even exist. That's like saying, hey, I want $1 billion.
Come on, Mr. President. Show me the money.
What?
Show me the money. Show me the money.
Show you what money?
You had me at hello, tear? Nothing? No? Hey, Einstein. It's 1969. Jerry Maguire won't come out for another 30 years. No one knows what you're talking about, ass. Scott, Daddy's working, okay? And while you're here, try and use the big boy voice. Mr. President, allow me to demonstrate the awesome lethality of the Alan Parsons Project. Fire the laser!
Ah! Damage report! Damage report!
It's okay. Calm down. It's alright.
Well, actually, that was just footage from the movie Independence Day, but the real laser's going to be an awful lot like that. Yeah, scary.
Now, Dr. Evil.
Talk to the hand, because the face didn't want to hear it no more.
Wait, whose hand? Talk to your hand?
You ain't all that in a pack of potato chips.
What are you talking about?
Don't go there, girlfriend.
Mm-hmm. Whose girlfriend?
Don't mess with me, I'm one crazy mofo. I had to pop a cop, cause he wasn't giving me, he props in Oak Town. No, I heard that somewhere.
You're an idiot.
Mr. President, and I think we have an understanding. Bye-bye.
Dr.Evil, what are your plans regarding Austin Powers?
Austin Powers! He's no longer the snake to my mongoose. Or the mongoose to my snake. Either way, it's bad. I don't know animals. But I do know this. This time it's personal. Kill him.
This Dr. Evil's island. Let's set up camp. This could be dangerous.
Dun 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 dun. What if God was one of us? Dun 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 dun. Just a slob like one of us. Dun 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 dun. Blue 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 blue. Yeah blah blee blee blee.
Dr. Evil, that was fantastic.
Thank you, number two. I wrote that. Yeah.
Dad, he put this in my bed.
Who?
Your stupid mini you. He put roadkill in my sheets.
Wait, mini me, don't you ever do that again. You hear me? Don't you ever do that again.
I can't stay mad at you. Look at that punum.
Dr. Evil's headquarters is right over that next ridge. Let me look. Damn it. How do we get in?
Oh. Hello, Mummy. Can I have some chocolates? I want some Mars balls. Don't smack my bottom, Mummy.
Austin. Sorry, love. Got caught in your dirty pillows.
Let's look at the map. Austin, what's our plan?
According to the map, the entire island is crawling with Dr. Evil's guards.
I want to make sure the explosives didn't get wet, but I can't find them.
Look in the bottom.
Okay. I'll dig a little deeper. Wow, this bag is really full.
Just keep digging, darling.
I'll feel around for them. Good Lord, Austin. What do you keep in here?
Anything that catches is my fancy, you know.
Give it a good tug. Do we really need this?
I ask you not to open that inside, thank you very much.
Oh my God!
Psst. Oops, it went off. Yes, oops, it went off. Yes, it does that from time to time. Ah, yuck! It's nasty, sorry about that.
Smelly.
These people make me sick!
Can you snap me a beer? What is this? A gerbil? How did that get in there? How did that get in your bag? I don't know.
Oh, God!
Dr. Evil! We have a problem. Austin Powers is on the island.
Bring him to me! Alive!
You.
Hit it!
This is a very sensitive subject.
Yeah!
From the moment I heard Frau say I had a clone, I knew that I'd be safe because I'd never be alone. An evil doctor shouldn't speak a lot about his feelings. My hurt and my pain don't make me too appealing. I hope Scott would look up to me, run the business of the family, head an evil empire just like his dear old dad, give him a love and the things I never had. Scott would think I was a cool guy, return the love I have, make me want to cry, be evil, but have my feelings too, change my life with Oprah and Maya Angelou, but Scott rejected me. C'est la vie, life is cruel, treat you unfairly. Even so, a god there must be, mini me, you complete me. Just me and you, getting jiggy with it. Yeah!
Just the two of us, Just daddy loves you, daddy loves you. Just the two of us, you and I.
Got this packed really tight. Oh, are you okay? Yeah, I just got a bit of a back cramp, that's all. Just keep packing them in. I found the explosives, help me check them.
You're surrounded! Drop your weapons! Move out!
Ladies and gentlemen, in just a few moments we're going to place a giant laser on the moon. From my Death Star, I will destroy every city on the planet. Ah, Mr. Powers, Miss Shagwell, welcome to my hollowed out volcano. This is my associate, Fat Bastard. Miss Shagwell, I believe you two have already met? Yes, unfortunately.
Oh, is that all the thanks I get for the night of hot sex?
I'm dead sexy. You a crap.
In your dreams, Felicity would never shag with you. Right? I did what I had to do, Austin. I'm a secret agent.
Oh.
Oh,
boo-hoo!
Okay, Fat Bastard, listen. As much as I love seeing Austin Powers in agony, and I do, the thought of you naked is just gross. You can't stop me now, Mr. Powers. I have your mojo. And I'm taking it with me to the moon. Put them in a jail cell!
My mojo! I'll get you, Dr. Evil!
Ooh, look at me, I'm shaking in my little space boots.
I want my mojo!
Great plan, Einstein. You're gonna put him in a jail cell with one inept guard and they'll escape.
God, you do this every time!
You know, Scott, I've been a frickin' evil doctor for 30 frickin' years, okay? Cut me some frickin' slack. You forget, Scott, we're in a volcano. We're surrounded by liquid hot magma. What are you drawing? Just a little goodbye card. That's all. Aw, it's sweet.
Ah! Get him! Get the baby!
Get down, he's my posse. You take special care of him.
He's a special boy!
Attention. Prepare for launch. Come, Mini-Me! Burp, burp. Attention. Prepare for launch. Frau, begin the countdown. Five, four, three, two. Frau, how about you count back from 30? 30, 29, 28, 27, 26, 25, 24, 23, 22, 21, 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13. Frau, when the doors close, just say go. Okay. Go! Commander, we have a situation here. What is it, son?
I don't know, sir. But it looks like a giant dick.
Yeah? Take a look at our starboard. Oh my god, that looks like a huge pecker. Oh, where? Wait, that's not a woodpecker. It looks like someone's privates. We have reports of an unidentified flying object. It is a long, smooth shaft, complete with two balls. Hey, that looks like an enormous wang. Pay attention. I was distracted by that enormous flying... Willy. What is that? Oh, it looks like a giant... Johnson.
Yes, sir. Call British Intelligence. Notify them about this immediately.
Ah! Austin, what do we do? Why don't you just go shag fat Boston again?
Austin, this is no time to get jealous.
Well, how could you do it?
I was doing my job.
No, I mean literally, how could you do it? The man's so fat. The mechanics of shagging are mind-boggling.
Austin, don't throw your anger on me just because you lost your mojo.
Ouch, baby. Very ouch.
Look, Austin, we're running out of time. I'm sorry. I just did what I thought you did. And in the same situation, you're the reason that I wanted to be a spy. I thought I wanted to be like you. But then I realized I want to be with you.
You do?
Yeah. Hang on.
Alley-oop! Oh.
We should talk about this later. We need to get past that one inept guard.
Here's the plan. What if I pretend? And to be ill with food poisoning, the guard, drawn by my cries of pain, you dig a pit, line it with makeshift punchy sticks, made from sharp toothbrushes, the guard falls and Bob's your uncle, we escape. What do you think?
That might work, but what about this? What do you think of these, my man?
Mommy!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to my moon base. You've all been chosen to be part of my elite unit, which is divided into two divisions. Moon Unit Alpha and Moon Unit Zappa. In exactly 6 hours, the movable moon in its orbit around the Earth, bringing Washington, D.C. within range of my giant laser. Begin laser ignition sequence.
Begin laser ignition!
Mm-hmm. All I asked for was a frickin' rotating chair, okay? Getting a little afraid. I need an old priest and a young priest. The power of Christ compels you. The power of Christ compels you. Okay, sick as a dog. Gonna vomit.
We need to hitch a ride to the moon, baby. Launching. 3, 2. Ah!
Whoa! Arm the laser.
Arming the laser!
Get me the president. You're gonna like this part, Mini-Me. This is the part where we threaten the world leader. I know we do it every time. However, it is important that we Mini-Me? Where are you? Can someone put a frickin' bell on him or something? Great. Someone grab a stick. Just grab onto the hook, all right? You complete me. I love you. I love you. You complete me. Hang in there, Mini-Me. If anything should happen to you, I don't know what I'd do. I'd probably move on and get another replica, but there'd be a 10-minute period there when I would have just got inconsolable.
We have your money, Dr.Evil, but it wasn't easy.
Papa has work to do. You have exactly 30 minutes to get it to me. Ciao.
Jiminy jumping Jesus! Can't believe we're gonna pay that madman! Got nukes up the yin-yang! Just launch one for God's sake! No!
Are you suggesting that we blow up the moon?
Would you miss it? Would you miss it?
Mission Control, the swing has landed. Let's find Dr. Evil. There he is.
I'll cover your rear.
No, baby. You go on ahead. This time it's personal.
Yeah!
Glasses. Oh, bless your little heart. Peace? That's not right. Poor little bugger. He's so small.
Oh!
off! Get it off! Ah! 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 Ah!
Gotcha, you little bugger!
Oh! Oh! No! No! Not my suit! Oh, that tickles! Stop! Please stop! Poor little bugger. I salute you.
All right, slaphead.
Where's my mojo?
Looks like you have a choice, Mr. Powers. Save the world, or save your girlfriend.
Austin! Felicity! Don't worry about me, Austin. You have to save the world. Kill him! Fire the laser! Ugh. Judo kick!
Target missed.
You may have won the battle, Mr. Powers, but you lost the war.
No! Wake up, Felicity! Wake up! Felicity!
I love you, Felicity. I love you.
Dr. Evil! I'll kill him! Ah!
Ow! You shot me, you a-hole! And now I'm going to kill you. Okay, but first...
Know this, Austin. I am your father.
Really? No, not really. I can't back that up. Right, idiot, yes. But isn't it strange, Mr. Powers? You'd rather kill me than save your precious Felicity. What do you mean? Remember, there's a time portal in the main chamber. You could go back and save her. I'll do that.
Good work!
Looks like you have a choice, Mr. Powers. Save the world, or save your girlfriend.
Austin! Felicity! Don't worry about me, Austin. You have to save the world.
I choose love, baby.
Who are you? I'm you 10 minutes from now.
Damn it! You are handsome! And thanks, so are you. We are sexy. We are
sexy bitches, baby, yeah!
Okay, this is goddamn ridiculous. Kill them both! Fire the laser!
Listen, Past Austin, can you save the world while I go get the girl? Sure, Austin, 10 minutes from now.
Judo kick! Target miss. You alright?
Yeah.
Say, what's the police on Menage a Troy? You are adorable!
Looking for this, Mr. Powers?
My mojo!
No.
See you in hell, Powers!
Self-destruct in 2 minutes.
Oh, no. Austin, 10 minutes from now.
Oh.
This place is gonna blow. Let's go. Come on.
Let's go.
My mojo.
We have to go now.
My mojo. I'm useless without it.
But you don't need it. You've had it all along.
What do you mean?
You've saved the world, you defeated Dr. Evil, and trust me, you're gonna get the girl.
Okay, maybe later. Come on!
I'll set the controls for 1967. Felicity, wait, why don't you come with me to 1999?
I don't know, I mean the 60s were so groovy. I want to see what the 70s and the 80s are like.
The 70s and the 80s, I looked into it, you're not missing anything. There's a gas shortage and a flock of seagulls. That's about it.
I love you, Austin Powers. And I love you, Felicity Shagwell.
Wherever we go, there we are.
Special delivery! Surprise, surprise! And now I'm gonna kill ya! Listen, Missy, you fancy another go? Cause once you've had fought, you'll never go back. You shut your mouth, you bastard! Who is fat? Before you kill us, let me ask you something. Are you happy? What kind of stupid ass question is that? I'm rich and I'm dead sexy.
You didn't answer my question. Are you happy?
Course I'm not happy. Look at me. I'm a big fat slob. I got bigger titties than you. I got more chins than a Chinese phone book. I've not seen my willy in 2 months, which is long enough to declare it legally dead. I can't stop eating. I eat because I'm unhappy. And I'm unhappy because I eat. It's a vicious cycle.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I gotta get in touch and forgive someone. Myself.
Oh, God. Sorry, I farted. It's a long road ahead. Oh, who am I kidding? I'm gonna kill ya anyway. Judo chop! Oh! Right in the mommy daddy button! That's what you get for calling me crap, you fatty! Ah!
Listen, Felicity, I don't care if he is a fat bastard.
You don't give a man a... kind of shorten the pills, it's just not cricket. Do you think I'll be happy in the 90s? Well, I know the 90s might sound boring, but as far as I'm concerned, I've brought the best part of the 60s with me. You. Wait a minute. Where are you going? Did we get Dr.Evil? No, sir. He got away. He got away in the rocket that looks like a huge
penis. The male reproductive organ, otherwise known as tallywhacker, schlong, or wiener? Any of you kids want another wiener? Daddy, what's that? I don't know, son. It's got great big nuts, hot salty nuts. Who wants some? Lord almighty! That looks just like my husband's one-eyed monster! Step right up to meet the one-eyed monster! Ah! Hey! What is that? That looks like an enormous...
Woody! Woody Harrelson?
Can I have your autograph?
Sure, no problem! Oh my lord! What's that? It's so big! Nah, I've seen bigger. That's...
just a little prick.
You've been in the coldness of space. It's a flu shot. I didn't want you to get sick. It's one thing to attack me.
It's quite another to attack my mini-me. I'm gonna get you, Austin Powers. I'm gonna get you!
Evil, evil is the one and only name. Evil, in his mind there is no other game.
Got more important things to do than my time.